A wife leaves her abusive husband in the new movie Till Death Do Us Part. We're rolling film right now.
What's up? It's Russell here at Howell's Hollywood Reviews, and if you guys haven't already, go ahead and click that bell notification icon. You'll get notified anytime I bring a new movie release, a new trailer release, anything new, you'll get notified. Today I'm going to be reviewing Till Death Do Us Part. It is rated PG-13 with a runtime of 101 minutes. Its director is Chris Stokes, and it stars Stephen Bishop, Annie Ilonzeh, Taye Diggs, and Mark Chapman. Pretty much this movie is in contention probably for the worst movie of 2017. Michael and Kate are the two main characters in the story, and they are getting married. Kate really wants to have kids. He really doesn't, and we see later on that he takes testosterone hormones in order to stay infertile. And so he is pretty much this knight in shining armor who ends up being an absolute animal. He starts hitting and abusing Madison, and she ends up leaving. And we find out later on that she becomes pregnant, and she fakes her death and ends up starting anew. And that is the basis of the movie. And we find out that she ends up being neighbors with Taye Diggs' character, and they end up forming a romantic relationship. And Michael, her ex-husband, finds out about her still being alive later on down the road, and that's pretty much the premise of the movie. This movie is like a Lifetime movie gone wrong. The acting is awful. I have seen better acting in porn movies. This movie just does not belong being like released out into the wide open. And there's a reason why this movie didn't get a really wide release, and because it's awful. Like I said, it takes the idea of sleeping with the enemy, mixes the fact that she's pregnant, and adds watered down awful acting, and this is when you end up with this movie, Till Death Do Us Part. Like I said, there's nothing really good about this movie. You'll find this movie probably on the Lifetime channel, probably within the next year or so, I'm sure. Yes, I understand it. It points the domestic abuse side of it is nothing to joke around about. I understand that, and I commend them for trying to bring a light to that. But the movie is just so bad acting, and it's just awful. And like I said, there's nothing I can recommend about this movie. I would stay far away from it. There is a reason why it didn't get a wide release, and this is it. Like I said, I would probably give this movie a 20 out of 100, and that's just being generous. The 20 is just basically for the fact that they actually got this movie out to get a wide release. So like I said, stay away from it. Waste your time on other movies. And if you guys haven't seen, Sleeping with the Enemy is a way better story and way better acting. Like I said, it deals with the same exact storyline that this movie does, and it actually does it a lot better. So that's really it for that movie, and until next time, we'll see you in Hollywood.